Brown Boots by R.P. Weston and Bert Lee. Our Aunt Hannah's passed away. We'd her funeral today. It was a posh affair, and to have two policemen there. The hearse was lovely, all plate glass, and wore a coffin, oak and brass. We'd thousands weeping, flowers galore. But Jim, our cousin, what do you think he wore? Why, brown boots. I ask you, brown boots. Fancy coming to a funeral in brown boots. I will admit he had a nice black tie, black fingernails and a nice black eye. But you can't see people off when they die in brown boots. And aunt, who'd been so very good to him, done all that any mother could for him, and Jim, her son, to show his class, rolls up as if to make it all a farce in brown boots. Oh, I ask you, brown boots, while all the rest wore decent black and mourning suits. I own he didn't seem so gay, in fact he cried best part of the way, but straight he regular spoilt our day with his brown boots. In the graveyard we left Jim. None of us said much to him. Yes, we all give him the bird. Then, by accident, we heard he'd given his black boots to Jim Small, a bloke that had no boots at all. So perhaps Aunt Hannah doesn't mind. She did like people who was good and kind. But brown boots, I ask you, brown boots. Fancy coming to a funeral in brown boots. And we could hear the neighbours all remark, what, him chief mourner? What a blooming lark. Why, he looks more like a bookmaker's clerk in brown boots. That's why we had to be so rude to him. That's why we never said how do to him. We didn't know. He didn't say he'd given his other boots away. But brown boots. I ask you, brown boots. While all the rest wore decent black and mourning suits. But some day, up at heaven's gate, poor Jim, all nerves will stand and wait. Till an angel whispers, come in, mate. Where's your brown boots?